My name is Cliff Sadoff and I'm an extension specialist at Purdue University. And in this video, I want to talk to you about leafminers. Leafminers are insects that feed between the upper and lower surfaces of leaves. And I'm standing in front of a hawthorn tree that has been attacked by the hawthorn leafminer. Now, when you look at these leaves, you can notice it looks like many of these leaves are brown at the tips. And you might think that this was caused due to lack of water, like some sort of scorch. But actually, there's a little larva that's living in this brown part that is feeding on the leaves. These mines happen to be rather old. The damage occurred a couple of weeks ago. So all that's left in here that we're going to find is just the feces that the larva left.
When you hold a miner-infested leaf up to the light, you can see a larva or just its excrement. In contrast, a scorched leaf will not reveal excrement or pellets when held up to the light. Leafminers can be managed by using a systemic insecticide to kill newly hatched larvae that are feeding within a leaf. This can be accomplished with soil-applied insecticides or foliar products that move into the leaf that can reach actively feeding larvae. Due to timing issues, it may be difficult to get effective control with products that only kill adults. For this reason, it is important to identify the leafminer before selecting your management options. The Purdue Plant Doctor webpage, available at purdueplantdoctor.com, can help you identify the leafminer if you can identify the plant it is attacking. Most smartphones have features that can help you identify your host plant from a photo, or you can use a free app like Seek. The Plant Doctor webpage has thumbnail images of plants that can help you jog your memory if you're not that clear on the identification of the plant. So let's suppose you have a plant that you think is a columbine, which is a flower. You could scroll down to the image of a columbine, and if you wanted to get a high-resolution photo to confirm that you did indeed have a columbine, you could do that, then close the photo, and then click on the photo itself, and you could then select the green bar with the foliage to get images of problems that occur on the foliage. And the first one that pops up is, surprise, surprise, a leafminer. And you can get a good look at it with a high resolution photo to confirm that that's what your problem is. And then closing it up, you can then click on the photo to review the key features of the leafminer, review its symptoms, its biology. It is caused by a fly. It has multiple generations a year. And you can apply systemic insecticides when the injury is detected. And compounds like abamectin and spinosad seem to work quite well. Although soil-applied systemic insecticides like imidacloprid, dinotefuran, and clothianidin are quite effective at controlling most leafminers, they can also be quite toxic to pollinators. For this reason, their use needs to be avoided on trees and shrubs that are highly attractive to pollinators and prone to leafminers. These include hawthorn leafminer on hawthorn, birch leafminer on birch, holly leafminer on holly, linden leafminer, and the elm flea weevil. Fortunately, the leafminer injury on these plants rarely, if ever, harms tree health. In contrast, boxwood can be severely damaged by boxwood leafminers. But boxwoods are not a major pollen source for pollinators. As such, systemic insecticides can be used to knock back heavy infestations, with the understanding that miticides may be needed to manage spider mite problems later on in the growing season. So please be sure to visit our Plant Doctor webpage, and don't let your plant problems get you down.